What do the physicist Albert Einstein, the composer Philip Glass, and the songwriter and lead guitarist of the band Coldplay, Johnny Buckland, have in common? They all share a love of and expertise in both math and music. Albert Einstein, an accomplished violinist and pianist, played music when he struggled with math. Philip Glass wrote an entire opera entitled Einstein on the Beach, which is based on his love for math. And Johnny Buckland has a degree in mathematics and has incorporated math themes into his song lyrics. Playing the oboe and doing math are two of my favorite activities. When my course teacher mentioned that math is the closest subject to music, it caught my attention. I started playing the oboe in fifth grade. Sixth grade was the year that math started coming more easily for me, and it became my favorite subject in school. 2 years later, as an eighth grader, I still love playing the oboe, and math is still my favorite subject. Just this year, I realized that playing the oboe has been helping me in math class. This fall, I started noticing the connection between math and music in my everyday life. For example, recently my band teacher was talking about sound waves and how, depending on how close the notes are together, the larger or smaller the sound waves are. Every sound wave can be written as a numerical number or equation. Another example was in dance class, when my teacher told the class that when she's struggling with understanding the steps of a combination, she thinks of it as a mathematical equation. As I thought more about this topic, I wondered, do either of these subjects make you better at the other? I believe the answer is yes. Playing an instrument would gradually help you in math class as you advance. This happens when you start counting beats per measure and dividing rhythms in your head when the time signature changes. Knowing math when learning an instrument works in the opposite way, because knowing ratios, proportions, and division help you keep time as you play. I ask a few teachers and students their thoughts on the correlation between math and playing a musical instrument. Everyone reported that they were aware of the connection between the two subjects. Saddle River Day School mathematics teacher, Mr. Lipper, said, "Mathematics teaches us how to apply certain rules and analyze relationships. I unwittingly use these disciplines when playing with other musicians to determine when to come in, how loudly or softly to play, when to solo, when to fade out." Frances Wood, my grandmother, who played the flute and is a retired elementary school teacher, said, "The connection between math and music was pretty direct for me growing up because I learned the piano and math at a young age, so fractions, measures, and different kinds of notes informed each other. If you're going to be really proficient at music in our Western culture, you really need to understand math concepts to stay on rhythm and read sheet music." As I did more research, I found a number of studies on the connection between music and general academic achievement. A study entitled Long-Term Positive Associations Between Music and IQ by University of Toronto's psychology professor Glenn Spielberg showed that students who regularly play instruments generally score higher grades on standardized math tests compared to students who don't play instruments. Martin Berge, professor of music education and music therapy at University of Kansas, was skeptical about what he called the overhyped interpretations of the correlation between math and music. After studying over 1,000 middle school students, he actually found the opposite. There is a positive correlation between music achievement and math and reading achievement. These results were statistically significant at both the individual student level and the school district level. A research study by Harvard developmental psychologist Nadine Gabb showed that people who frequently play instruments have higher executive or brain functioning skills opposed to non-musicians. These skills are essential for mathematics. To really answer my question, I suggest that a study be made that analyzes a group of students and their math skills before starting an instrument, as well as again after they have been regularly practicing. A long-term study like this would really show whether music training strengthens math ability or whether math skill strengthens music ability. The academic research does not attribute a specific cause for the correlation between music and general academic achievement. It could be that the discipline of playing the same thing every day makes for good study habits, or that a part of the brain that is stimulated by music also helps with general academic achievement. Whatever the causation, it is known that there is a statistically significant correlation. This is important. A recent trend in schools across the U.S. is to cut music programs due to funding or desire to fill the day with additional test preparation to boost test scores. If policymakers in our country paid attention to data showing that playing instruments helps with general academic achievement, they could better advocate for strong music programs. If parents paid attention to the correlation, it might influence their willingness to urge their kids to participate in singing classes or playing instruments. So next time you listen to some classical music, or even a more busy genre like pop, try and hear the mathematical beats between each note. Or next time you're stuck on a math problem, try listening to a little Coldplay. Thank you.